Hey everyone, Dave, Display Fireworks One. We are on our way to a fireworks demo right now. We're headed into the state of Ohio to American Fireworks in Hudson, Ohio. Now you may be familiar with them if you followed some of my videos. I paid their facility a visit, I don't know if it was last year or a couple years ago. I have a couple of their display shows on my website. Pyro on the Roof, I know, is one. Pyro on the River. They sell consumer fireworks and the Dominator line of articles of pyrotechnics. Now, if you're not familiar with that, you'll have to look back over my videos on what those APs, I like to call them, or articles of pyrotechnics are. But with a lot of people moving into firing systems and this sort of thing, if you don't have an ATF license, this is something you may want to consider. Now the demo tonight, I know, is going to have just consumer fireworks. There will not be any of the articles of pyrotechnics tonight. Now, this is the first time I've ever been to one of their demos, which I'm going to guess is designed mainly for their retail customer base. So we'll keep that in mind when we go to this. We should be there in about another hour. They like my Gordon Freeman glasses. You know, anybody know who Gordon Freeman is? Half-Life 2. Just wanted you to check them out. All right, we should be there in an hour.
Okay, we're on the Pennsylvania Turnpike. In a short distance here, we'll be in the state of Ohio. So if you're coming from, look, here's our buddy sign up there, Phantom. I think one of his places is around here somewhere. Now, if you're coming from the state of Pennsylvania, here, we're coming into Ohio now. Depending on where you live, you may want to take this turnpike to get there.
Continue 31 miles on I-76 West. Recalculating. Continue 54 miles on I-76.
Okay, you'll want to come this way and just stay on this road, which, you know, I'm coming from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania over, and the GPS took me this way. These tolls are really inexpensive here, if I remember right. Now, when I was growing up, I always remember driving from Pennsylvania into Ohio. And as soon as we would come into Ohio, I would always notice that the speed limit was actually higher in Ohio, and the roads were always so much better. So we'll see. I haven't been out this way in probably a year, or maybe less, I don't know. But anyway, we'll see if that still holds true with the difference in the road. Well, we are in Ohio now. This exit here is the Youngstown, Ohio exit. This is where Phantom Fireworks has their, I think it's this exit or the next one. I know it's the next one up here, Youngstown. 1 mile. Phantom Fireworks has their main headquarters here. What's interesting is I keep trying to make it, see if they'll let me come down there. They have, and I would imagine they still do, it's the last remaining American-made sparkler company in the whole United States that makes sparklers with the metal rod instead of the stick. This may be why I think we saw the, how many years back was it, all these sparklers that were sticks instead of metal. I wish I can articulate the whole story correctly, but there was a tariff, you know, they were to save the last remaining sparkler company in the United States. They put a tariff on the importation of sparklers into the United States. They were accusing the Chinese of dumping sparklers in this country. So the tariff was for any sparkler that had a metal rod that was part of a sparkler, because, I mean, if you go back to the late 60s, early 70s, all sparklers were metal rods. And I think it was called the Elkton Sparkler Company, or there was probably a few. Diamond, I think, was one. But Phantom Fireworks actually owns the last remaining sparkler company in the United States. And they gear up for production, as a matter of fact, right around this time of year. to get ready for the 4th of July, and then they shut it back down again. And I keep wanting to make it down there, but I'm not sure how welcome they'll be to cameras. But we're in Ohio, we're still traveling along. A lot of fireworks history on the way to Ohio, that's for sure.
Roads are fairly decent here in Ohio. Here's something to think about when you're traveling and looking for gas mileage. Is it better to have a V8 that turns less RPMs at a higher speed? You can see here I'm going almost 80 miles an hour and the engine's barely turning 2,000 RPMs. So for gas mileage, is it better to have a car, a big engine turning less at a high speed, or a small engine screaming at a high speed for gas mileage? And I heard that, you know, that a V8 sometimes that's geared properly can actually do fairly decent with gas mileage. Anyway, just thinking about dumb stuff on the way there, I guess. Now, coming up here is the General Motors plant. This is where they make the Chevy Cruze at. I think this is the... There's some sitting down there. The Lordstown plant. Lordstown, Ohio. Today's Saturday, so it's not much going on. So if you got a Chevy Cruze, this is where they're building. You look at the plant right here. See the big sign. Home of the Chevy Cruze. Okay, it's telling me to get off exit 187 on the Ohio Turnpike, so that's what we're going to do. They're nice homes here. I think we talked about this once before. This place had to be grandfathered in with some laws in the area about where you can build a fireworks place, because you can't imagine that these people would ever let something like a fireworks place be built anywhere near their homes here.
In 0.1 miles, turn left on Darrow Road, then arrive at address 7041.
See,
on
left. We're like that close.
41, on left.
Okay, here we are. American Fireworks. Right up this road. Right off the main road. It's 41 degrees, so I would imagine it will be nice and cold later on today. You can see where they're starting to set things up here. And I would guess they will electrically fire it, but we'll have to wait and see. Okay, we're here at the building, and if you didn't see my tour from last year, the whole facility behind here, but this is their retail section. So we're gonna go in and look. We're here early. The demo and the food and things are gonna start about an hour from now. So we'll just do a little quick walk around. Okay, see what's typical with demos is when people come, you get one of these lists of what's gonna be shot tonight. Now, this year is different for them. They're carrying Legend, Dominator, and they added Winda into the lineup tonight. So these are their three main brands: Legend, Dominator, Window. And they go through each one and just shoot it, and at the end they're going to put a show on. Some of their prices, special prices for the demo.
Snapping noises up here.
So if you look here, all prices not marked special demo price will be 50% off the register.
They accept Visa and cash, credit card, both. Now, while you're here, you want to join an organization? Someone I should look into. Looking to start a, get into a new organization myself. Join the PGI. It's nice of them to put that right here. You can get that. Take your fire. See, this is a rule. It's a consumer fireworks in the state of Ohio. You know, even if you live here, you sign. It's just so stupid, I guess. You sign a paper that you're going to get them out of the state of Ohio within 48 hours. And you should always keep your receipt. It's a good point here. Right. You're going to sign saying you know about this. Even if you don't feel like following it, that's what you're going to do. Always start with firecrackers. Right. Now, I don't know how they're doing the pricing, if it's going to be half off at this price or not. Yeah, evidently, I thought I heard him in the background. It's half off today. Everything's half off. 50% off the prices today. Is it good or bad? I don't know. It's up to you. Everybody got their own pretend M80 looking thing, right? Now, when you see some of the firecrackers that are available in other countries, it makes ours look mild, but it's the best we can get. Windows. See, this is new for them, window products. Someone told me the story behind Winda. Winda's really Panda fireworks, but they couldn't use Panda in the United States, so they come up with Winda or some crazy story like that. Well, that's pretty heavy. Fountains. These are always fun if you know, don't nail them to a tree. You know, my experience has been when I use these, you know, so let's just pretend we're just talking, you know, a side shot here. When I nail them, I usually nail them so they lean a little bit this way. So they, just a slight angle to them where they can spin and don't bang into the device you have them nailed to. These little novelty things are always favorites. Drooling chickens. Tanks. Pistol poppers. Oh, it looks like bottle rockets. Stick rockets. Cheap fun. Whistling bottle rockets. Things have been around for years, some of these things. Occasionally, like I told you on the way up here, you'll occasionally see some phantom items. So while they're in competition, they have some alliance with each other, I guess, to sell some of their products. Now, I've seen some of these Legend products. This is a thing now that I'm seeing a lot of, ring rockets, smiley face rockets. The ring rocket and the smiley face, it's how it's going to be oriented and how it breaks, depending on what you're going to see. Legend brand. Little small devices. Here. Okay, now we're getting into the artillery shells, which I think is always the best value for your money. My favorites are always the canister shells this year, but if you prefer a mix, it's multi-breaks. Now, is that a true canister shell? I don't know. It may or may not be, to be honest. I can't tell 100%. The multi-breaks. Small kits. So everything's 50% off. Remember, this is retail. Volume. Now these feel like true canister shells right here. Just by feeling how heavy they are, it's a winded product. Canister shells again. These canister shells are getting big and popular. Fiberglass mortar. These little things like this can surprise you sometimes. These little tiny little, I've seen these over the years where some sound really great. Same with this too. Not that they would recommend it, but sometimes people just light these on the ground. Look at that backpack. Take a look over here. Sparklers. We talked about these on the way up, different stick sparklers.
That'd be something fun to do for the neighbor.
Let's see, this is, these are stick sparklers too. Morning Glories, always a favorite. Inexpensive too, usually.
Lots of sparklers.
Trying to see if we see any of those metal rod sparklers. Let's see. These may. I can't tell without opening. May or may not be metal rod sparklers. Snakes. See, here's some more Phantom stuff popping up from time to time. Are they good? I don't know. There's some are real good, those snakes. Those spin up in the air. See, look, here's, you know, 50 cents if it was half off. Not sure what they do though. Oh, there's a spark. This looks like almost from their 1-4 AP line. Didn't know they sold them like this. Yeah, strobe, yeah, it might be, pro.
Okay, I just wanna get the tape.
Strobe pots are always neat. If you get a music that has like a drum, fast drum roll in it or something like that, you can play these. That might be like their jumping jack. I don't know. crown blooms. Single shot items. And now we're coming in 500 gram cakes. Oh wow, look at all these parachutes. Yeah, I could see the Winter brands coming up, popping up here and there. It's a retail price, $31.99 for these. Dominator, I think, makes a few of these strobe cakes, and I wish I knew them all, but I've seen people shoot four of these at one time, and it's pretty dramatic effect in the show. There's probably a whole psychology behind how you set up a fireworks store, you know, when you first come in. Oh, here it is. Here, maybe this is the one I'm thinking of here. This strobe cake. I can't remember. It may be that one. I'm not sure. This is a good cake, and it's priced good too, if I remember right. Oh, this one's everybody's favorite, grenade extractor. That one used to be really good. I've seen this one around. Because I remember that Joker dude right there. Some legends. Okay, the final combinations here. I know last year they had their assortments here. It looks like they're already pre-made this year. Some people can't make their mind up, so they get one of these. Alright, that's a quick run through the store. A couple items here in the middle. And we'll go from there. They have a fence up here. This is sort of retail night, so to speak. So they don't want people roaming around the property. So everything's fenced in. I actually, on video, have a great tour of this whole facility, including those storage containers, which are used to store 1.4 fireworks. They have some other magazines throughout the property here. And this is a working area where they build things. And they have a salute magazine way out in the middle of the property out there. But you'll have to see my other video if you really want to enjoy that. All right, let's see. Okay, we're going to take a walk up just to see how it's set up. My guess is it's all going to be electronically fired. It's either going to be a fire one or something up here. We'll see. It is so darn cold. They said no matter what they do, it either rains or it's cold or something for these demos. So you got to do the best you can do. All right, let's go up. This feels mushy, man. Must have rained here pretty bad yesterday. All right, we'll take a look. Okay, they're setting everything up with the Fire One system. And they'll probably run it in manual mode and just press buttons and go from there. You can see where they daisy chained. Let's see how they did this. Tough to follow the wires. Oh, they went all the way around. They took the long way. See, the fire one, you give each module a number and then you disconnect two wires here. And then if you look, it's, here's this one and this one. It daisy chains into this one. And then they'll take a wire. In other words, a wire goes from here to here, and then a wire goes from here to the next one, next one, next one, next one. So in theory, you can connect them all together. This is the Fire One system that's the module and the rail together. Now you can get the module separate, plug it in to an existing rail, and I forget what that term for that connection is, where it plugs in. They probably got different options on that. This was originally designed for the indoor guys. You know, you're climbing a roof to put something, climbing a ladder, instead of taking a rail and a module, you just take the whole thing with you. And these connectors here are pretty durable. So they're a display company, and that's what they're used to working with, so that's how they set it up. This is part of their AP line, Article of Pyrotechnics. They're going to shoot these as part of a pyromusical and not part of the demo. Oh, wait a minute, maybe they might have the demo set up different, but we'll see. This is probably part of the pyromusical. They usually don't like to demo these to the public right here, because technically the public cannot buy those. You have to have some degree of being involved professionally in fireworks. While you don't necessarily need an ATF license, they have to know that you know something. A PGI membership is usually good. A member of a professional fireworks club like the Cracker Jacks, this sort of thing, or this club here in Ohio, they'll accept things like that. But you know, the average retail guy coming in with $50, like, hey, I want to buy these, you know, he doesn't know how to set them up, let's face it, right? He's going to light it and lean it against a tree or something. All right, let's see how they did this. Yeah, it's more Fire One. The whole show's set up like that. Oh, look, they took all the precautions, you know, they have everything in a box, keeping it stable. These are probably their professional boxes. They just throw these cakes in it. You just have to be sure to set it up right. Now I'm going to guess that they put the match right into the cake. Yeah, that's what it looks like. If you know what you're doing, you could tear the visco fuse out and get a device and dig a hole to make it bigger, stick the electric match in there, and it'll give you more precise firing, particularly with a pyromusical. That's what you want to do. It's a little time consuming, but you'll get more precise firings that way. I'll let those guys do their setup over there without disturbing them. Got pretty good clearance from the audience. That's about it. Okay. It's nice to see them add another brand here, you know, Legend, Dominator, and Winda. You know, I'm not an expert on retail sales. If I would ever have a fireworks business, I would carry all the brands and try to make deals and just have a selection of everything, which is, looking back on it, some of my favorite places to go would do that. As opposed to, say, TNT Fireworks, Phantom Fireworks. Now, when you go TNT Fireworks, you're going to go and that's all you're going to see is their brand, you know. It's like the Aldi's of fireworks, right? You're going to go in, you're going to see their brand and nothing else. And then they compete that way. Which is good for them, because they're selling a product that no one can compete with in price-wise, right? They're the only ones that carry the brand. You can't price comparison them, so to speak. But if you have a stand selling a little bit of everything, gives you a good selection, but then you could turn around as a retail customer and say, hey, I saw that on the internet, $10 cheaper. But you can't do that with TNT or Phantom because they're the only one selling it, right? There's a great video I saw where this guy in Alaska has a video where they're buying fireworks for a holiday up there. He goes to where they're selling and there's two stands. There's a TNT stand and then there's another stand that sells all these different brands. And you can see where all the people are not standing at TNT's, they're standing at the other place where the selection's better. So it pays off to carry more than one brand, I would think, you know, but it's up to them. All right, we'll get a shot of the board. I just saw there's a professional photographer, videographer here that is coincidentally a member of my website, pyrotalk.com, and he will post his video in addition to mine. Now, his is going to be more defined for how to look at the product, so if that's what you want to do. You can see here how they're going to shoot it tonight with the Fire One system. I'm going to see where the wire's coming in. Oh, there it is right there. One single two-strand wire will fire everything right here. And they'll connect it up and put this in manual mode and just press the buttons. We're starting to get some people now. People in the area, some of their retail customers, some people are in here buying stuff. And we're just waiting till dark now. Okay, we're just hanging out here, so we're going to take a look at some of what's going to get shot tonight. Starting with the Legend brand, I don't know if these are all 500 milligram cakes or not, but according to what I'm hearing, these are special prices just for the demo on these products here. Moving into Dominator. Here's different ones here. Some of the more common ones. Now this one here is an all-time favorite. Where is it? Haunted Fish. That's a good one. Some of these strobe ones are. I've not seen the Dominator artillery shell yet. The canister ones, I don't know if it's in this mix or not. I forget what they're called. Now, Winda has a canister shell in there that I think is, it feels like a good one, but I don't know. Let's see here. The Windas are new this year for them. Oh, which one of these have I had before? Can't even recognize any of them. Which ones are good or not? I think that Pyro Candy's a good one, if I remember right. Let's see. This, on the Legend brand, grenade extractor, if I remember right, is a good one. So we'll have to see. They're going to start with Legend, Dominator, and go from there. So we're just going to hang around and wait until dark. See what goes on. See, they got a professional photographer here. Some music, and at the end, they're going to have a little pyromusical, which should be kind of
cool. Like I said, we'll get started here in about 10, 12 minutes.
You guys cross-checked, right?
No, I like
that. Oh, when you're labeling them?
Just run manual fire, and here's the, this is the, give you a shot of this system here. It's a wireless module. Connects to the board. Sends the signal. Plugs in just like a module. Right there. I got my flashlight to show this to you. Let's see. See right there how it plugs in. Connects right there. Not sure how well this will show up at night. You can see it's like a family event here for some people. Bring the little blanket, open the car up, bring the kids, check the demo out, right?
5 minutes, waiting for it to get a little darker, but about 5 minutes. All right, everybody, we're going to get started here. I'd like to thank everybody for coming out to the 2013 American Fireworks Demo. We have about 47 cakes that we're going to shoot off here, all of which are available in the store. For those that have a sheet, they'll be available for the price you see on the sheet. Everything else in the store will be 50% off. After the actual cake's being shot, we're going to have a 7-minute pyromusical. Now, all the stuff that's shot during that pyromusical is consumer fireworks, so it's going to be a nice all the music, about 6 songs, but I'd like to thank everybody for coming, though. I know it's a little cold out here. At least we don't have wind. One of these years, we'll get a warm one, but thanks a lot for coming out, and we'll see you in the store afterwards. All right, so we're going to start with the Legend 500 gram cakes. Number one, Commando Operation. Number two, Expendables. Number 18,
The Haunted Fish.
Haunted Fish.
If you haven't seen this one, you'll see the It doesn't look like a haunted fish. Let's see. Maybe it's toward the end. There it is. It's like a flying fish fuse in there. Now, this looks best if you shoot more than one at the same time. There it goes, they're hanging a little longer. There we go. We were hanging a little short there for a minute.
Number 40, Pyro Candy.
Yeah, this is a good one, I remember. Nice. Deep sound, hear it? Not on that one. Maybe this one. The third one. Not bad.
Number. Alright, so that concludes the demo. Like I said earlier, all the stuff we just shot will be in the store, and it'll have a special demo price label on it, also listed on the form. Anything that's not marked special demo price, you can take an additional 50% off. So if something's $20 in the store, when you get to the register, it'll be $10. What we're going to do now is we're going to move on to our pyro musical. Like I said before, this is all consumer fireworks that will be shot in this choreographed show. All right, guys, thanks for coming out tonight. Like I said, the store's open until everybody leaves, so you guys are more than welcome to come in. There should be some food left in there as well. Thanks for sticking out the weather, and see you inside.
Okay, there it is. The fireworks demo, American Fireworks, Hudson, Ohio. Hope you enjoyed it. I'm on my way home. Should be home in about 2 hours. Now, they tell me that the majority of their customers are from the state of Ohio. Now, if you come in from out of state, they're certainly welcome your business. If you're interested in that Articles of Pyrotechnics, the AP line, they carry the Dominator brand, you're going to have to prove to them that you know something about fireworks. Now, how do you do that? Of course, having an ATF license is going to help. Or you're a member of a fireworks organization. The PGI, Pyrotechnic Guild International, would be an example of that. And you have a membership card to show them. Now, what you want to do is, before you come to purchase any of those articles of pyrotechnics, please call ahead of time. You know, remember who you're talking to, tell them what your certification is. You could even copy it on a copy machine and fax it to them. This sort of thing, something to think about. All right, that's it, guys. I'll see you in the next fireworks adventure. Thanks for watching.